compile and interpreted languages. All source code have to be converted to machine code, and are two ways on doing this. The first is compiling the source code, and the second is interpreting the source code. Let's take an example for you understand better these two concepts. Consider this. You have your computer, and I have my computer, and you are going to write a program for me to run it. With the compiled language, you write your source code, and you have a program called compiler, that will go to that source code, and create a separate file that contains the machine code. Then, you just send me that file. This file you just sent me, is also known as an executable file, because now I can directly execute it, and run your program. You keep your source code, and I never see it. Now with the interpreter language. You don't compile the source code to send to me, you just give me a copy. So, I need on my machine, an interpreter, whenever I want to run your program. The interpreter is different from a compiler, he does this on the fly, we can think as going to your source code, line by line, processing on the moment, and does not save as a separate machine code file. You probably already used an interpreter language. Every time you surf the web and go to a web page with JavaScript, then you already used. This is what being happening. The JavaScript, and in other web files like images and web pages, has been sent to your machine over the web as source code, and the browser have interpreter for you to be able to see it. Now let's see the goods and bad sides from one to another. The compiled language, is ready to be executable, is ready to run. He can be optimized for the CPU so he can be faster. And you don't have to send your source code, is private. On the downside, is not cross-platform. If you compile on PC, he won't run on a Mac. Is inflexible. Needs to be compiled even for different processors in the same platform. And you have to make an extra step. Because you have to compile always whenever you want to test your program. Now in the interpreter. Interpreter languages are cross-platform. Because you don't provide machine code, you just send the source code, and let the other side to take care of it. It's more portable, to be tested in other platforms. It's also easier to test, because you just write the source code, and then run it, letting the interpreter to converting it. And it is easier to debug. Because you always have access to the source code. On the downsides. Whenever who needs to run your program on their machine, has to have an interpreter on that language to be able to run it. It's also can be slower, because you have to interpreter every time the program runs. And the source code, is public. Now, because they are good things on the compiled and interpreter languages, it's also a third way on doing this. Instead on the compiler module, when all the work is done up front, but can be a little inflexible. Or, the interpreter module, where all the work is done on the receiver side, but can be a little slower. You can do half and half. Before you send anything, you compile part of the way, which is called, Intermedia Language. Which is still not machine code, but can be portable across platforms. And then, who received this file, can take the last step to take to the machine code on their computers. This procedure is also known as Jit Compilation. And this intermedia language, is also known as bytecode. So this process is to happen somehow. Is just how much in your machine, and how much on mine. Now, which languages are known as compiled languages, and what are considered interpreted languages? For example, C, C++, Objective-C, are considered compiled languages. And the compiler can be downloaded for free. But is also integrated into integrated environment applications. On the interpreted side are languages like PHP, JavaScript, ActionScript, and most languages with the script word in the end are mostly interpreted languages. And languages like Java, C#, Python, VB.NET uses the intermedia hybrid approach. If this is something to take in consideration, if your priority is maximum speed and in one single platform, you should choose a compiled language. If the idea is to be moving your code across platforms, you probably be interested in the interpreted. More usually, you are driven in what you need to do. build iPhone or Android apps, Windows applications, or dynamic websites, or in our case learning the basics of programming. Then, you let the decision to choose the appropriate language, a compiled, interpreted, or intermedia one.